U.S. Marine sniper stands on a landmine and becomes trapped in the desert for 52 hours waiting for help. That's why today on the Summarizer, mine. In an important mission in the middle of the desert, we see Mike, a skilled American sniper, and Tommy, his spotter and assistant. They're on top of a rock waiting for a convoy to arrive with a dangerous terrorist whom they must eliminate. As they talk, a group of civilians arrive walking to the scene. Seconds later, the convoy can be seen approaching while Mike receives indications on how to act. The vans stop, and from one of them, the target they are to assassinate gets out. A wedding was being celebrated in the place, and Mike tries to attack his target, but doesn't get a clean shot. Suddenly, one of the combatants sees the reflection of the sun in the sniper's sight, so he shouts and alerts the others. The target retreats into the van while the others fire at the soldiers. Mike and Tommy flee on foot, trying to camouflage themselves with the surroundings. The fighters give chase, but the soldiers manage to hide behind a rock. When they're about to find them, one of the gunmen gives the order to retreat as a fierce sandstorm can be seen rapidly approaching. Inside the storm, the soldiers take the opportunity to move and call for help over the radio. The command center tells them that an immediate extraction is impossible and orders them to head for a town to the west. Sometime later, the storm passes, and we can see the two soldiers walking in the sun. The wind blows a metal sign with strange letters printed on it with a danger sign. Tommy tells them that the sign is a false signal to keep the enemies away, and there is really nothing to worry about. Mike is not so sure about that and tells him that it could indicate the presence of landmines under the sand. Tommy tells Mike to keep moving towards the village, and the guy follows him from behind. Shortly, Tommy steps on one of the mines, and when he lifts his foot, he flies through the air. Mike is stunned and tries to go to help his partner, but when he takes a step, he hears another one of the mines activate under him. Mike realizes this, so he stands still because if he stops putting pressure on the mine, the bomb would detonate. The radio was in Tommy's backpack, so the agonizing guy injects himself with morphine to relieve the pain and tries to reach the radio. Tommy tries to communicate with the command center, but is unable to do so. His wounds are very serious, he's bleeding to death, and since no one can help him, he decides to end his suffering. Mike is devastated, but he must resist. He gets down on his knees and takes out his knife, with which he checks that he is really standing on a mine. He then removes his bootlace, takes off the sniper's rifle holder, and assembles a kind of improvised hook with a tactical axe on the end, which he uses to hook his partner's backpack and bring it closer to him. When he tries to use the radio, he realizes that he has no battery left, so he takes a portable panel out of the backpack and charges it. After a while, he tries to communicate with the military base again, and this time he succeeds. Mike reports his and Tommy's situation and asks for immediate evacuation with explosives disarmament. The other side tells him that their vehicles are not yet in use because of the sandstorms, but that there is an allied convoy that could pass through their location in 52 hours. He further suggests to him that the mine might be old, so there is a chance it might not explode when he lifts his foot. The communication cuts out, and Mike activates a 52-hour countdown on his watch. Later, while he eats something, he realizes that a strong sandstorm is advancing towards him. Mike grabs his rifle with one hand and his knife with the other and sticks them into the sand to brace himself so that the fast-moving winds will not be able to knock him off his feet. When the storm passes, Mike sees that his friend is by his side. He decides to take the batteries for the radio that were in Tommy's vest, but when he looks for the backpack, he sees that the wind blew it several meters away to an unreachable distance. The boy laughs with some insanity and shoots into the sky, hoping that someone hears him. Soon, a man appears from the dunes and Mike tries to communicate with him. He shouts, warning him of the minefield, but the guy ignores him and keeps moving forward. The man speaks some English and seems to know how to get to Mike without stepping on any explosives. As he gets closer, he tells him that he has to take the next step. The guy is very confused and tells him he can't do it, to which the guy points to his canteen. Mike gives it to him and then asks him to please get his radio. The man tells him that the radio doesn't play good music and insists that Mike take the next step. Then he leaves while Mike yells at him, trying to explain that he can't move. After a while, the man's daughter appears and runs up to Mike with her canteen. The girl hands it back, full of water, and he thanks her while the girl pulls a toy soldier out of her bag. The man pulls one out of his vest and gives it to the girl to play with. Seconds later, Mike asks her to reach for the radio, and the girl looks at him. The man gets desperate and yells at her, so the girl runs away. More than 38 hours to the rescue are left when night begins to fall. Mike eats an energy bar and then improvises a small fire with some sticks that were nearby. At night, Mike's fire goes out. out, and he tries to rekindle it, as it is the only thing that protects him from the wild animals. After a while, Mike hears some howling nearby, so he shoots with his friend's gun, trying to scare the animals away. The jackals approach and take Tommy's body. Mike shoots one of them that, when running away, detonates a mine, scaring all the other animals away. The next day, the man appears again and asks his name. The man asks Mike why he is not a free man, and suggests that he is a lucky man because he survived a night in the desert with his foot on a mine. The guy assumes Mike is afraid and tells him that every day his step could be his last, so what's the difference today? Mike tells him that even if he is a lucky person, there's only a 7% chance that the mine will not explode when he steps off, and again asks him to hand him the radio. The man gives it to him, and Mike tries to communicate with the base, but to no success. Moments later, the man tells him to become a free man and then leaves. At dusk, Mike starts to hallucinate and starts arguing alone with someone invisible. Moments later, he sees his friend Tommy get up from the sand, saying that it is almost time to go home and that he will stay by his side. At night, Mike hears his cell phone ringing and tries to reach it. His friend tells him he is crazy since there is no signal there, but then shows him the cell phone with a call from his father. In the hallucination, Mike remembered how his father abandoned him when he was a boy. He wants to survive so he could see his wife Jenny and not abandon her like they did him. Soon after, a pack of jackals approaches Mike and attacks him. The boy defends himself as best he can with his gun and a knife, while the wild animals pounce on him. The next morning, we can see Mike shivering and bleeding still with his knife in his hand. The clock shows 7 hours to his rescue, and the boy grabs the radio to communicate with the base. They tell him that the convoy was attacked and is overdue, so he must survive another 17 hours before they reach his position. Mike is devastated, but the commander passes the microphone to his wife. Hearing her voice, Mike apologizes for leaving her alone and regrets the decisions that led to the situation he's in. He then hallucinates seeing her in front of him and begins to fade away, falling forward. Luckily, the man who has been helping him appears and holds him up, preventing Mike from lifting his foot off the mine and exploding. As he heals his wounds, the man tells him that a long time ago he too stood on a mine that blew his leg off. He tells him that he thought his life was over at that moment, as nothing would ever be the same again, but he was still able to recover and is now a happy man. Mike listens attentively and congratulates him for having such a nice girl who helped him by bringing his canteen. Confused, the man tells him that his daughter died a few years ago. It turns out that they are very poor, so they were out mining to sell them to the army, leaving a small metal can instead. One of these excursions, his daughter stepped on one of the mines, causing it to explode and dying on the spot. Mike is confused, as he had seen his daughter. When she finishes healing him, she gives him a strange substance to drink and then leaves. As he walks away, Mike sees his daughter again, but she quickly disappears behind a cloud of sand. After a while, Mike starts hallucinating again, and he sees his father who used to beat his mother. He remembers the beautiful times he spent with his wife and also his mother in a hospital bed fighting for her life. Suddenly, Mike is pierced by a bullet and realizes that the terrorists who were looking for him have found him. They keep shooting at him, but Mike quickly grabs his pistol and fires several shots into the sand until he detonates a mine which gives him some cover. He then grabs his rifle and shoots until he runs out of bullets, killing them all. Mike is badly wounded, and soon after, he sees the rescue convoy in the distance. Unfortunately, the rescue team cannot see the soldier due to the large sand dunes and the camouflage of his clothing. The boy needs to get their attention somehow, and sees a smoke grenade lying in the sand a few meters away. If he manages to activate the grenade, the rescue team will be able to locate him. But to reach it, Mike has to move, setting off the mine that could eventually kill him. He quickly remembers the story the man told him and what he said. No matter what happens, we have to take the next step. We always have to continue. Then Mike realizes that it is better to risk taking the step than to die in that desert alone and without being able to see his wife. Mike is ready for whatever may happen, so he walks forward, releasing the pressure on the mine. Surprisingly, the explosive did not detonate, and Mike falls to the ground very confused and decides to dig up the mine as the man taught him, and in doing so discovers that there was not a mine, but a rusty metal can. Mike opens the can, and inside he finds the toy soldier that the daughter of the man who took care of him used to play with. At that moment, he realizes that there used to be a mine in that place, but the girl had dug it up, putting a tin can in its place. Mike lies down on the sand with the soldier in his hand, and begins to laugh in gratitude to the man and his daughter who had once again saved his life. Mike pulls the grenade, and the team goes to rescue him. In the meantime, he understands the important life lesson that this experience and the man have given him. No matter how difficult your situation is, you always have to move forward. You always have to take that step. Mike returns to his hometown where his wife is waiting for him. He approaches her and drops his bag and kneels down, suggesting that he will never leave her alone again. That was mine. Comment which series or movies you'd like me to summarize for future videos. See you later.
Go to work.
Okay. Bye.